I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions.
Who do we find here at these ceremonies honoring Corporal Sean Kelly, who passed away killed in the line of duty with the Denham Springs Police? We're at Denham Elementary. But John Wascom, chairman of the parish council, you know, this kind of thing is not exactly in your job description, but boy, the whole community has come together. I want to use the word celebrate. There's this, true, it's solemn, but it's an air of celebration here today, too.
Being raised here in Denham Springs, it's our home, and it's a close community, Ken. I mean, we work with people, we are friends with some, we disagree with some, we love some, you know, but to get at the end of the day, we're all in Denham Springs. I believe we have a connection and it's a family, and being on the council in District 4, which is the city limits of Denham Springs and a few small surrounding areas. I mean, I knew Sean back when I used to be on the city council years ago, and it was a sad day for Denham Springs, and of course it spills over into the parish. And I'll tell you something, I'm really glad to see the sheriff and other communities outside of Denham Springs, from south of Denham and Springfield, and I see Walker and other areas showing up to come in to show support, and then the children from the elementary school getting involved, and the Kiwanis Club. It's heart touching.
You know, in some of the big cities that we know too well, there must be an attitude among many police forces, who cares about us? Who cares? We get killed, or officers are killed every day. Does anybody care? You would certainly not feel that here in Denham, just the opposite.
No, absolutely. I think, I don't know if it's the South, I don't know if it's just Louisiana, or I don't know if it's just Livingston Parish, but we have that thought, that feel that, you know, because, I mean, our children are in law enforcement. Our families work for these law enforcements. And, you know, I personally have a son who's in law enforcement in Livingston Parish. And, you know, when something like this happened, it's home. It's personal. So,
well, let's talk about the parish council, if we may. The airport is back in the news. After many years of seeming to languish, the proposal has gotten some new legs. What do you think?
Let me say this about the airport, Ken. I am really excited to see the Livingston Parish Airport. I was on the council 8 years ago when we established this commission, which they might have been established just before I got there, but I believe it was right about the time I took office 8 years ago, the commission got started. But they've been working on this for years ago. And there's a small opportunity, a small window, when things come together. And it just so happened, this particular time, right now, that window is open. And I'm excited about it. I really am. I mean, where else can you have the FAA say, okay, evaluate your entire parish and say, you only have two spots that we are going to support. And then to have one of those spots, have someone come to you and say, oh, by the way, I'm going to donate 250 acres that's in the middle of that spot. Where else would you have that opportunity? And to not take full advantage of those things, it would be an injustice. And so I'm excited. We've had a bunch of things just happen to finally work together, fall in place at the right time. And so, the gentleman that gave the land to the parish, he said, with one stipulation, 250 acres I'll give to you, except if you don't put it into an airport, you got to give it back to me. So we were just excited about that years ago. And of course, funding was, because we're not going to pull money out of local tax entities. We're not going to put a burden on local tax residents in Livingston Parish. So the commission went to work in Baton Rouge and the D.C. trying to get funding. And sure enough, they did. So it's just, things are falling in place, and I believe it's going to happen.
But, you know, there's an air of almost anti-development in Livingston Parish. Like somebody told me, if it's a lady putting a beauty salon in her garage, they'd be against that. They'd be against just any development, yes, much less an airport. And one fellow said, look, I'm stuck in traffic every day on I-12. Why should these big shots get their airplanes?
Yeah, I mean, that's like saying apples and oranges. That's, you know, it's two different things. You know, if you might say, well, we're going to fix this road. We've been working on a bridge for 20 years, and you finally get the funding to do it, and somebody says, oh, but this bridge is in worse shape. You can't just change horses. You got to go try to fix that one with another pool of funding. You know, as far as development, you're right. The pendulum has swung in Livingston Parish to where it's a lot more anti-development. I think the pendulum swung too much development for so long, and it's caused an overburden on our infrastructure, our schools, our drainage, our traffic, our
lots of things.
Police, and water, and sewer. So yes, that's exactly right. So I think the pendulum is a lot more tighter, and I just hope that the council can just keep that in check and don't shut the entire parish down.
So, in the what else is going on department, apparently in November there'll be a ballot initiative to rededicate the 1 cent sales tax. What gives?
Now we'll see. Now I believe that's going to be for the 1 cent toward the jail you're talking about. Is that?
Well, it's cut two ways now, and they want to include animal control as another beneficiary of that tax.
Yeah, what we do is, as a council, what we've done is allowed the sales tax was passed years ago, the jail had an outstanding bond, I think $7 million or $4 million a year of debt service that they had to pay or something like that.
And it was paid off last year.
And it got paid off. So what we're doing, because that money's dedicated for the jail and they don't have the need for that, maybe they have future plans for expansion, and if that's the case, then what we'll do is that money has to stay for that. But just to let it sit in a bank or something is not necessarily the best thing to do. So I'm thinking that we'd like to ask the population if they want to allow us to use that money that's above and beyond the debt of the jail to fix roads, animal shelter, drainage, stuff like that.
Originally, the wording included the health unit too, but that was pulled apparently somewhere along the way.
Yeah, I believe we put the health unit. It's going back to the ballot. I believe we voted to allow it to go back to the ballot.
Just for the health unit?
Yes, just for the health unit.
How many meals would that be, by the way?
Ken, I couldn't tell you that right now. Let me get to my office. I'll call you.
But I mean, you know, the thing with the health unit is that it was defeated, but then they cut the millage in half, and it came back and passed, and then it got defeated again. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, you know, I think a lot of people are not sure the benefits of a health unit, and you know, with today, I think that might have played into it, and so we'll just wait and see how that vote goes, and hopefully people will get out, vote, make an educated decision.
What else are you working on?
You know, right now as chairman, we've got a couple things pushing coming down the pike. I know I've heard conversations about working on maybe the home rule charter. I think there are some things that in the home rule charter that need to be changed that they adopted years ago, but that has to go to the vote of the people. Again, we need to work hard to get a commission to get that back going. And then I've heard some field art ordinances, but I think they're still working on that. So I'm really not sure what's the next, when the page turns tomorrow morning, I'm not sure, but we'll see.
Hi, I'm Trent Anthony with Monument Real Estate. After working several years in the real estate industry, I decided to serve the wonderful people of Southeast Louisiana by opening a locally owned company where each client is treated with a tremendous amount of respect and importance. Serving the North Shore, Baton Rouge, and New Orleans regions, Monument has the ability to broker all types of real estate transactions. Your real estate needs are very important to us, so let me or one of our team members help you make your mark with Monument Real Estate.